Are you in your teens and hopeful to grow big and tall? Or an athlete who wants to prevent future fractures? Calcium is the answer to your wishes. Your entire skeletal system relies on this essential mineral to keep its framework hard and strong. You may remember someone telling you as a child that drinking milk helps your bones, but it does so much more than that. So, what do we need calcium for? What are the possible signs of its deficiency? Where can we obtain it from? Today's video is going to discuss all that and a lot more. Let's begin with why we need calcium. Number one, it prevents osteoporosis. More than 200 million people worldwide have osteoporosis, a bone condition characterized by bone density decline, fragile bones, and altered bone structure. Have you ever seen a honeycomb? It has clusters of cells with small spaces between them. Similarly, your bone's internal structure has teeny tiny holes, which widen with osteoporosis, causing them to lose strength and density. As the sturdiness of your bones declines, you become prone to fractures that can also affect the quality of your life. So, how can you avoid this? Well, if you maintain a healthy and calcium-rich diet, you can regain your bone density. Osteoporosis is more common in females of growing age than males. This is because women have lower peak bone mass, the greatest amount of bone mass an individual can attain, and smaller bones than men. However, men above the age of 70 are still at risk. Calcium is an essential nutrient that can help you reach peak bone mass. If you don't have enough calcium in your diet, your body will take it from your bones, which leads to bone loss, leaving them weak and brittle. When looking at bone strength in postmenopausal women, the numbers have always shown an upward trend. Every 1 out of 3 women above 50 can expect to experience an osteoporosis fracture in their lifetime. These fractures can occur due to the lack of estrogen in postmenopausal women. After all, estrogen is one of the hormones responsible for calcium absorption in females. Remember to add vitamin D to your diet, as these work best together in reducing fractures and strengthening your bone structure. This is because vitamin D helps absorb calcium from the intestines. Vitamin D is usually made in the skin after exposure to sunlight. Ensure you're getting enough of this essential vitamin through natural sources such as sunlight exposure, dietary intake, or supplements. Number two, moving on, how do your calcium levels affect your cardiovascular health? Balanced calcium levels are crucial for maintaining your heart's well-being. High calcium levels in your blood can raise your blood pressure by enormous amounts, which can easily trigger a stroke or heart attack. Not only this, it can even lead to the formation of blood clots, causing blood vessels to narrow. This is known as the calcification of arteries, and it restricts the blood supply to your heart, eventually leading to a heart attack. Since high calcium levels lead to a heart attack, suppose you reduce your calcium intake and your levels plummet, leaving you calcium deficient. What next? Studies have shown that insufficient calcium levels in the body can trigger the excess release of parathyroid hormone, which is responsible for regulating phosphorus and calcium in your body. This parathyroid hormone will ensure enough calcium moves through your blood to restore your levels. When this happens, it decreases phosphorus absorption and fixates all its focus on absorbing calcium. The process will continue to the point where you amass more calcium in your bloodstream than needed, which would lead to heart problems. So, inadequate calcium levels will leave you worse off, whether low or high. This is why doctors advise you to monitor your calcium levels, maintain a healthy quality of calcium in your diet, and keep your arteries free of calcification. Number three, what about calcium's role in preventing colorectal cancer? Did you know diet and nutrition contribute to almost 50% of cases of colorectal cancer? And calcium-deficient diets are associated with the majority of these cases. Colorectal cancer is the 3rd most common cancer in males, while 2nd most common in females worldwide. Studies have shown that a calcium-rich diet protects against colorectal cancer. The colon and rectum are parts of the large intestine responsible for the reabsorption of water and mineral ions, such as sodium and chloride, from your food after passing through the small intestine. Most of the large intestine consists of the colon, a tubular structure from where the whole digestive system or gastrointestinal tract ends. Colorectal cancer can start from both the colon and the rectum. But how does calcium prove to be beneficial in preventing this cancer? The answer lies in calcium's ability to stop hyperproliferation, the rapid division of cells. Cancer is a disease where cells divide hastily and spread to nearby tissues. However, a calcium-rich diet ensures that this rapid cell division ceases at its initial stages, so development cannot occur. Studies have shown that high calcium intake may reduce the risk of colorectal cancer and terminate the possibility of the occurrence of colorectal adenoma, which is a non-cancerous tumor. What are the symptoms of calcium deficiency? Calcium deficiency symptoms may not surface in the early stages, but become prominent once the insufficiency progresses. Some of these signs include: Number 1, paresthesia. A ticklish yet burning sensation in the arms and legs of individuals. It's commonly referred to as pins and needles. Although the sensation may not be painful, the itchiness can irritate you. Number 2, muscle spasms known as tetany. You may experience involuntary movements with painful contractions that can be highly unpredictable. These muscle spasms or cramps can be accompanied by numbness around the mouth or paresthesia. Number 3, another sign of calcium insufficiency is cognitive impairment. If you cannot recall events or people, make decisions, and are constantly confused, these are vital signs of cognitive decline due to nerve damage caused by low calcium levels. Number 4, depression. Do you constantly feel anxious? Do negative thoughts never leave your side? Do you feel an ever-growing sadness taking hold of you? If you answered yes to any of these questions, then there is a fair chance you have depression. Depression can lead to mood and behavioral changes. You become agitated on trivial matters and feel alone, even when surrounded by those closest to you. Low calcium levels might not solely cause depression, but sometimes they may trigger the prevailing condition. Number 5, a telltale sign of calcium deficiency is fractures. Calcium deficiency can push you one step closer to experiencing fractures more often. Increasing calcium intake is crucial if you want to be free from a plaster cast around your limbs, as low levels lead to low bone density. Number 6. Next up, we have weak and brittle nails. Calcium is a significant component of your nails, and its deficiency can leave you with fragile ones. If you love to do nail art, you understand how difficult it is to see it get chipped and broken. Increase your calcium intake to avoid any further nail chips and damage. Number 7, and lastly, calcium insufficiency can also show pre-symptoms of a heart attack. Low levels of calcium can cause disruptions in the regular functioning of your cardiovascular system. It can trigger uneven heartbeats, chest pain, and heartburn, resulting in a stroke or even heart failure. With symptoms out of the way, let's focus on good sources of calcium. An average adult between the ages of 19 to 64 needs about 700 milligrams of calcium daily. And if you're not a big fan of calcium supplements, then rest assured you can quickly fulfill most of that requirement through what you eat. There's a wide variety of food items rich in calcium. However, milk is one of the most widely available and best sources of this mineral. Depending on the fat percentage, milk contains roughly 306 to 325 milligrams of calcium per cup and is easily absorbed by the body. Milk is also a great source of protein and vitamins A and D. Other excellent sources of calcium include cheese, soy drinks with added calcium, bread and anything else made with fortified flour, fish with edible bones such as sardines and pilchards, and green leafy vegetables such as curly kale and okra. And no, spinach doesn't count. Even though spinach is brimming with loads of calcium, your body cannot digest it because it contains a high amount of oxalate. This chemical interferes with your body's ability to absorb this mineral. However, spinach can be an excellent addition to your diet because it is abundant in other nutrients. Keep in mind that too much of anything isn't good for you. More than 1,500 milligrams of calcium can harm your body and trigger diarrhea and severe stomach pain. So avoid taking supplements unless advised by a doctor. It's important to ensure that our bodies are getting a good amount of nutrients to function properly. Calcium is an excellent mineral to ensure your body's structure stays healthy and intact. If you're interested in learning more about calcium, check out the top 12 calcium-rich foods your body is starving for, or 11 foods rich in calcium you must eat daily. Go ahead, click one, or better yet, watch both. What did you learn about calcium? Let us know in the comments below.